welcome to Northeast Kids Online. We're grooving into a new month and jamming out to a whole new life app. I mean, this is fresh out of the studio, friends. What are we talking about this month? Drum roll with me. Cooperation. Working together to do more than you can do alone. Yes, that's right. God made us to work together. Everyone has a part to play. Let's say this again, but at this time, play your air guitar at the end. Cooperation, working together to do more than you can do alone. Now that we're in the jamming spirit, let's get on our feet and let's worship together.
I will sing forever of your love, come down with my hands to heaven, shout your praises loud. I was lost in darkness when you pulled me out. I will sing forever of your love, come down.
Brandon, you ready for a jam session?
You know it, John.
Here we go. Thank you, everyone. We are the So and So Show Band, and we're here to rock your faces. 2, 3, 4.
stick with the guitar?
Let's stick with the guitar. Yeah.
Oh, hello all, I'm Brandon.
I'm John.
And this is the So-and-So Show. Hey, it's March.
Yeah, but we're not marching, we're jamming.
Yeah, okay. I know the show won't be able to continue if I don't do this.
You are correct.
All right.
Come on. Booyah.
Come
on. Oh, no.
March.
Okay.
Okay.
Woo!
All month long, we're in the midst of a big old jam session, and I love, what is that?
You know what? I'm not sure exactly what it is, but I know who it sounds like.
Who?
Someone who knows stuff!
Oh.
Yeah, everybody! This is Hans... Did he leave? Oh, this, everybody, right here. This is Hans... Everybody, this is Hans Decibel, and yeah, that's the one. Okay, this is Hans Decibel. He's our resident sound expert, huh? How you doing today, Hans? Why don't you get the, how you doing today, Hans?
Are you there, Hans? Hans! He's not there. Oh, yeah.
Hans!
Ah!
Oh!
I'm a friend.
Okay.
Sorry. Hello, Brandon.
I know, that.
Hello, Brandon.
Yes. Yeah.
Hello, John.
Hi.
Sorry I was...
No. Distracted.
Yeah, I'll say.
Yeah. You were... Would you mind?
Oh, no.
Perfect!
Oh!
I couldn't have done it without you.
Oh, good job.
Thank you. I am working on
a very important project.
Yeah, we can tell. You're off on another world.
Nine! No. I am not. I am on this world. This planet.
Yeah, it's a planet Earth.
Okay, but what's your project, Hans? Are you trying to document every sound there's known to man?
I'm making music.
Oh. Hey. Ooh.
Don't you need instruments to make music?
Nine, of course not, John.
No,
there are music all around us if we just listen. Sing fast.
What? Sorry.
Nine! Wunderbar! This was exquisite!
Oh, then you're welcome.
Yeah! Oh, I don't know, Hans. I'm not sure I've heard anything that sounds like music.
Music is in the ear of the beholder, Brandon. Everyone knows this? May I pinch you?
No.
Okay. May I pinch him?
Oh, yeah, go for it.
Why would you say that? Ah! Oh, perfect!
Ow.
Thank you for your sacrifice.
Yeah, can you please explain to us what we're actually doing?
Yeah, good, yeah, of course. We have been working together to create art. There are opportunities all around us. We just have to know where to find them. Listen.
That's actually incredible, Hans.
Yeah, this is correct. We make a good musical team.
Yeah.
We should form a band and traverse the globe together.
yeah, maybe.
Yeah. What should the band be called? It should be called Sound Splosion. Mm. Boom! It's like an explosion of sound.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah. I got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I look forward to your call.
Oh, yeah. Well, hey, thanks for coming by, huh?
Yeah.
I didn't think you had a phone.
Nine, I don't have a phone.
No.
Just
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Music is everywhere. Boom! Sound explosion!
It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey, fellas, how are you?
Oh, we're great, Kellen. What are we talking about today?
Well, today we're talking about the building of the tabernacle and how... Oh, boy.
Glad you came. Glad you're here. I know it's getting late, but never fear. We'll give a blow-by-blow of the Bible story on the Mel Solomon Story Recap. Thank you. Thank you. You're too kind.
How's it going, Melv? Here to help tell the story today?
That's what I do, Kellen. I'm Melv Solomon, here as always with my brother-in-law, Greg. Say hello, Gregory.
Hello, Gregory.
Tell what you tell, Kel, and I'll pipe in with a song when the mood strikes.
Oh.
Whoa, whoa, easy there, Greg. The mood hasn't stricken yet.
I'm sorry.
Take it away, Kellen.
Okay. You can find this story in the book of Exodus, the second book of the Bible. God's people, the Israelites, were wandering in the desert. God wanted a place to live among them. So, through a man named Moses, God told the people to build a sacred tent, or tabernacle. It was going to take a lot of planning and a lot of work to build, so the people were going to have to work together.
Work together? I got the perfect song for that. Hit it, Greg. What? No. No, 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 no.
What?
Not that song, Greg. You know how I feel about that song.
But I was just...
You know what? Go on. Get out of here. Take a rest. I'll do this on my own.
But I play...
Go! Go ahead, Kellen. I just need a second to figure this keyboard out. Can't be too hard.
Yeah. The people were going to have to work together. So God told Moses to have his brother and his nephews serve as priests in the tabernacle, which meant they would need workers who had the gift of sewing to help make robes for the priests.
So, a needle pulling thread, am I right? Hit it, me.
Make me a robe so shiny and new. I'll wear it now, unless it goes moo. No leather, everyone. Cruelty-free vestments.
Sorry. Oh, sorry about that. Carry on, Kellyon.
Thanks. The tabernacle was going to need more than just people who could make clothes. God had given special abilities to these two guys named Bezalel and Aholiab. They could work with metals like gold, silver, and bronze. They could also work with wood. God wanted the tabernacle to have lampstands made of pure gold and a golden ark to hold the Ten Commandments and a table for holy bread.
Ooh, ooh, have I got a song for that? That's not it. No, that's not it. Okay, hold on.
They also had an altar for burning incense.
Wait. Go back to the bread table. I have the perfect song for that. That's not it. All right, sorry. That's not it.
I'm not really sure what you want me to do.
Okay, bread table. Give me a bread table. Bread table.
Yeah, bread table. God told Moses exactly how the tabernacle should be built, and everyone wanted to contribute. People gave their talents. They gave materials. They took time to teach other people how to build and sew and craft. They all used their skills together.
Yeah, skills. Like my skill to do this. That's not right. No, it's... hold on. Yeah, What?
Melv, do you think you might need to work together with someone? Someone like Greg?
Greg! Come on, Greg. I can't do this anymore, Greg. Buddy, I'm sorry. I thought that I could do this on my own, but it just isn't true. And besides, you and me, pal, we go together, right? We're like peanut butter and jelly, ham and eggs, milk and...
Milk!
Exactly, Greg. Milk and milk. Melvin, Greg, come on. Back together again. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, Kellen, go ahead and tell me one more thing. I have the feeling we're in for a big finish.
Thanks. When all the work was done, Moses looked it over. He found that the people had worked with one another and with God. So the tabernacle was built exactly as God wanted.
That's it. Here we go. Hit it, Greg.
If you've got a job to do, you've got to do it right. Especially if that job's for God, for Him you'll work all night. In the snow and in the rain and all kinds of weather. Doesn't matter when you work, long as you work together. Right, Greg?
All right, Kellen. Lesson learned. Back to you, my friend. Sorry, Kellen. That's enough of the quack.
It is so funny.
It's very fun.
I didn't know that was on there.
Very fun.
See you, Melv. Could not have done it without you. Everyone has something they're good at. We all have some kind of talent. And there's a lot we can do on our own. But amazing things can happen when we use the gifts God has given us to work together. Thanks, everyone. I'll see you next time.
Thanks, Kellen.
Oh, hey. Hey, Hans just sent me a clip.
Oh,
yeah.
Reveal
the
question.
When have you seen people work together?
Yeah, I see people work together all the time. This show and you and I work together.
Yeah, working together can be something as huge as a giant crew of people putting up a building.
Yeah, or as small as working on a school project with a friend.
Yeah, we're about to work together to finish the show.
Yeah, let's do it.
Thanks for joining us this week, everyone.
Yeah, until next time, I'm John.
And I'm Brandon.
And this was the So-and-So Show. See you soon.
Yeah.
High five. Yeah, teamwork, baby.
I got it.
Okay.
Just hold it still. You keep moving it, don't you?
No.
You're not.
Nope. Is that the first time ever?
Yes.
I am never washing this hand again.
Oh, that's gross.
Yeah.
With God's help, the people worked together. They cooperated. They made a special tent where they could worship God and God would be with them. To build the tent, they needed people with all kinds of different gifts and skills. They needed designers, people who could sew, people who could work with stone and fine metal, and even teachers who could train others how to do these things. They succeeded because everyone came together to make the tent just as God instructed. Our bottom line this week is, God wants us to work together. You and I are kind of like the workers in the story. We all have things that we're good at. Maybe you're good at math, or maybe you're a good singer. Maybe you're good at taking care of your younger brother or sister. Well, God can work through us in big ways. When we put our skills, talents, and personalities together, we can do so much more than you could ever do on your own. If you think about it, even Jesus too cooperated. I mean, Jesus is God's son. He's all powerful, but Jesus chose to work with a group of 12 disciples as he traveled and taught people about God. Our memory verse for this month is Ecclesiastes 4:9. It helps us to remember why cooperation is so important. Our memory verse: two people are better than one. They can help each other in everything you do. Ecclesiastes 4:9. Thank you so much for joining me here at Northeast Kids Online. Friends, you have a wonderful week, and I will see you next time.